Tidak hanya di Indonesia, kebakaran hutan juga jadi masalah sejumlah negara lain. Kami ajak Anda mengikuti liputan khusus rekan kami Olivia Rosalia dan juru kamera Bondan Wicaksono di Amerika Serikat. Kali ini cerita soal penanganan kebakaran hutan yang jadi langganan bencana tiap tahun di Amerika Serikat.
Tak dapat ditolak, tak dapat dihindari. Kebakaran hutan seperti jadi langganan. Hampir tiap tahun terjadi di Amerika ketika kemarau tiba. Membakar ribuan hektar hutan, juga rumah warga. Tak jarang memakan korban jiwa. Hari itu Jim Reid mewakili pemerintah El Paso County, Colorado, menunjukkan langsung pada kami kerusakan hutan Black Forest karena kebakaran pada tahun 2013. Sebagian besar pohon sudah tidak dapat diselamatkan, hangus hingga ke intinya. Namun tentu bukan hanya kerusakan pepohonan yang jadi pekerjaan rumah setelah kebakaran hutan. Masalahnya kompleks.
Now the fire's out. What happens there? Now we have to go back to recovery. We have to say, what roads do we need to fix? How do we get homes with their power back? How do we get their gas back, their utilities? How about people that don't have homes? Where do they go? What do we do with those folks? And then after, as we go further, as people are taken care of, we look at how the fire has impacted the land. So when the ground is burnt so bad, it becomes hydrophobic, it doesn't hold water, and there's no trees or vegetation to hold the water back on drainage, and so that compounds it by 10, 20 times, it just gets even worse. So now we're dealing with drainage and other things that we have to deal with, and these are long-term things. This community is going to take years to recover, years, it's not going to happen overnight.
Masih di Colorado, kami juga berkesempatan datang ke Waldo Canyon, hutan yang terbakar pada 2012. Hanya satu tahun sebelum kebakaran melanda hutan Black Forest. Dua tahun berlalu, Waldo Canyon yang jadi salah satu tempat tujuan wisata masih belum pulih seperti sedia kala. Minimnya pengalaman membuat pemerintah maupun warga seakan kewalahan menghadapi api yang melalap pada pertengahan 2012.
To the right of me here is a lot of the burned area. It burned roughly 18,000 acres in national forest land and in unincorporated El Paso County. And then on day four of the fire, the wind changed and it blew into the city of Colorado Springs, destroying 347 houses and killing two residents. The fire was tremendously expensive. It was like $500 million of insured loss. So one of the lessons from fires like this is the earlier that you can detect them and get people on them is key. So early detection is a big, big part of it. A bigger picture aspect of it is forest mitigation, to have a healthy forest so that it won't support a devastating fire like this. When the trees grow too densely and they get older and then get diseased, that's exactly what supports a fire like we had in Waldo Canyon.
Kini ancaman bencana lain mengintai setelah api melalap Waldo Canyon. Banjir. Ya, banjir. Karena tanah hutan yang tak stabil setelah pepohonannya habis terbakar.
Well, when it rained, the flood came right down this channel, and the channel looked like the channel behind me that's all washed out. And it washed all this out and washed the road out. And it carried that debris, those rocks and sediment, down into the channel cascade, damaging homes and putting other properties at risk. Even though it didn't damage them, it made the road impassable. This road here was not passable at all. So what we had to do was put these rock checks in, and the county designed those and put them in and put the rock in behind you to restore the road to make the road passable.
Dan inilah yang tengah diupayakan pemerintah setempat, mengatur dan menahan aliran banjir di beberapa titik, dari puncak gunung hingga lembah. Tanah-tanah dipadatkan dalam karung-karung ini untuk menghambat laju air saat banjir terjadi, sekaligus mengarahkan air dalam satu saluran aliran. Di sisi lain pegunungan, sebuah proyek juga disiapkan untuk melindungi warga dari ancaman banjir dan longsor. Insinyur muda Kyle Bertis, salah satu anggota tim proyek ini, menjelaskan target yang disasar.
Highway 24 is a main access route through this area for tourism and basic industry, and to get through this part of the mountains, and that's Highway 24 up there on the ridge. And so after the flooding, this slope was compromised, and it threatened to wash the road away into the stream down here below. So CDOT decided to stabilize this slope through various means, and then as you can see, they've added this net infrastructure over the top and reseeded the slope to try to stabilize that. Down below, we have an access road here for a common picnic area and recreation area behind us, which is beneath a waterfall. So this area is heavily traveled, especially in the summer months. In order to protect that road and the base of the slope, what they did was they used these large boulders here and grouted them in place with concrete to protect the road, the base of the slope, and then also the flow line of the channel. And so what they did was they grouted more rocks in the actual stream of the channel to try and dissipate the energy and add rock drop structures that were more fortified, similar to the ones we saw up above, to try and hold the flow line in place and protect this area.
Namun sesungguhnya di balik semua proyek dan rencana yang disiapkan, kesadaran warga merupakan kunci utama. Kesadaran untuk terlibat aktif mencegah dampak buruk bencana. Kami kebetulan bertemu dengan Kathy Russell, petugas penyelamat kebakaran sekaligus satu-satunya pemilik rumah yang selamat dalam amukan api di Black Forest Juni 2013. Rumah Kathy tak sedikit pun terkena jilatan api ketika kebakaran melanda Black Forest, hutan tempatnya tinggal. Api dihadang dengan cara ini. Hamparan tanah dan bebatuan yang sengaja dibuat melingkari rumah. Perhatikan juga pepohonan di sekitar rumah. Agar api tak menyambar, Kathy sengaja memangkas pepohonan besar dalam jarak tertentu dari rumahnya dalam 15 tahun terakhir.
This is my house. If you look at the house here, you can see that there are no trees right up close to the house. There were trees here when we first moved in. We have cut quite a few of the trees away from the house. They're no longer there. So that when the fire traveled through the forest, it reached a place where there were very few trees or no trees. And at that point, there was no fuel to carry the fire. And the fire then dropped to the ground. When we came back home after the fire, the ground was black all the way around the house. The fire had come up through the grass and had finally reached a garden path and stopped.
Sayang, tak semua warga memiliki pengetahuan dan kesadaran seperti Kathy. Perlu upaya terus-menerus untuk mengajak warga aktif terlibat meminimalisir dampak bencana.
But that's always a challenge. What we found is after disaster, there's a really heightened sense of awareness of preparedness, and then it may go down. People get more comfortable, and so we want to continue to get the message out. And we do that through meetings and through our website and really engaging the community to make sure that they are prepared.
Media massa menjadi penentu pula untuk memastikan warga tak panik berlebihan ketika bencana melanda. Kami mendatangi stasiun televisi lokal di Colorado. Di sini berita mengenai cuaca buruk menjadi prioritas dengan target dapat membantu pemirsanya.
We have access or we have exposure to so many different people just who are watching one station. So if there's a commander of a fire that's trying to get important information out, if they can stay in close contact with us, we can go live to a major audience of people who are near their televisions to say, here's what we need you to know. Here's how we can partner with the media to let as many people know as we can in a short amount of time what is important and essential to know for safety, people's own protection, and anything to know that they need to know up to the minute. So a good partnership between those who are supervising the fire, you know, the fire or the flooding, gets that message out quickly to a lot of people.
Mengkomunikasikan seluruh rencana penanganan bencana dengan baik pada masyarakat. Dave Rose di kantor pemerintahan El Paso County menjadi salah satu ujung tombak mengkomunikasikan dampak kebakaran hutan kepada semua pihak.
Here in El Paso County, we have a large number of visitors, tourism. And during the Waldo Canyon fire, we would receive questions from people from out of state, from out of country. They'd say, well, can we come visit? Has the whole place burned down? Is Pikes Peak still there? Well, of course, Pikes Peak is still there. And so you have to plan your way through, how are we going to communicate to people? The fire's out. The businesses are open. Pikes Peak is still there. What's your plan for that? And of course, we're still recovering from those things.
Tak seindah dulu, tapi gunung dan hutan di Colorado masih jadi daya tarik dunia di balik ancaman kebakaran hutan dan bencana. Tumbuhan dan rumput yang mulai menghijau di kawasan ini menandakan tanah bekas kebakaran hutan di Colorado, Amerika Serikat mulai subur. Dan ini baik, tapi ada trauma yang masih begitu mendalam di kalangan masyarakat ataupun juga pemerintah setempat. Ada 4 orang meninggal. Ada kerugian setara dengan ratusan miliar rupiah yang harus ditanggung. Kami sudah mewawancarai sejumlah pihak yang terkait dengan penanganan bencana kebakaran hutan di Amerika Serikat. Dan jawaban untuk menghindari bencana lebih buruk atau menghindari korban jiwa ataupun kerugian yang lebih parah, menyiapkan mitigasi serta berkomunikasi dengan semua pihak, termasuk dengan masyarakat agar setiap dari mereka siap menghadapi bencana kapanpun itu datang. Olivia Rosalia, Bunda Nucaksono, Kompas TV, Colorado, Amerika Serikat. You ripple down the valleys, growing wide and swift and deep.